Welcome to a new video from EU Droneport. SORA, which stands for Specific Operations Risk Assessment, is like a safety roadmap for drone operations. It's a method developed by JARUS, Joint Authorities Rulemaking on Unmanned Systems, a group working on drone regulations. This approach helps ensure that when we plan and carry out drone missions, we carefully analyze and minimize any risks involved. The European Union has chosen SORA to meet its safety requirements for specific drone operations. It involves steps where we assess the operation, identify risks, and put measures in place to reduce those risks. Think of it as a structured way to make sure every drone flight is as safe as possible. Let's start at the beginning. Concept of operations. A ConOps is like a detailed plan for a drone flight. It includes all the important information needed for the mission, such as the highest altitude the drone will reach, the type of operation, whether it will happen during the day or at night, the schedule for the flight, the kind of airspace and land areas it will cover, and details about the drone and its equipment. Additionally, the ConOps defines the operational volume and safety zones in the air and on the ground, as outlined in the methodology. Think of it as a comprehensive guide to ensure a successful and safe drone mission. In the world of drone flights, there are basically two situations as defined by the semantic model in the SORA methodology. The first is what we call a controlled operation. This means everything is going as planned and we have full control over the drones. It includes routine operations with standard operating procedures, and if something unexpected happens, we have contingency procedures in place to handle it. The second situation is what we term uncontrolled operations. This occurs when things don't go as planned and we lose control of the operation. In such cases, it becomes an emergency, and we need to put our emergency procedures into action. This includes executing the emergency response plan to address the situation and bring things back under control. Drone operations are like a carefully choreographed dance, taking place in specific areas, both on the ground and in the sky. Let's break down these areas in simpler terms. Flight geography. Think of this as the main stage for the drone performance. It's where the drone is supposed to stay, both in terms of space and time. Contingency volume. Picture this as a safety net around the main stage. It's there just in case the drone decides to venture a bit outside the planned area. Ground risk buffer or air risk buffer. These are like backstage areas where only the crew is allowed. They're meant to keep people on the ground and in the air safe from any unexpected surprises. Adjacent area or adjacent airspace. These are the areas where the drone might end up if something goes wrong, like a dancer stumbling. We need to carefully consider things like how many people are around and how close we are to airports. In simpler terms, flight geography and contingency volume are where we have full control over the drone's movements. The ground risk buffer, air risk buffer, and adjacent areas are where things can get a bit tricky, and we need to be extra cautious. Let's talk about something crucial. Safety. Specifically, the risk of a person getting hit by a drone, which we call the ground risk class, or GRC. To figure out the initial GRC, we look at a few key things. First, the drone details. We consider the drone's weight and size. Bigger drones might carry a higher risk. Second, location. Where will the drone be flying? Is it a busy city or an open field? And type of flight. What's the drone going to do? Are you flying in line of sight or beyond it? Different missions come with different risks. Now, SORA comes to the rescue with a handy table that can be found in the article. With these three variables and the table, you can extract your initial GRC. All right, let's dive into how can we reduce this risk by applying mitigations. Here's what we do. Technical containment systems. For example, we use fences to avoid uninvolved people access. Impact reduction systems. Imagine these as protective parachute or airbags. If something goes wrong, these systems minimize the impact on people on the ground. Emergency response plan. Having a solid plan in case of an emergency is a must. It needs to be ready to use and proven effective. Now, with these mitigations, let's see how much we can decrease the initial GRC value. here's how it works. Robustness levels. Think of this as the strength of our safety net. It's determined by two factors: how much it improves security, integrity level, and how sure we are that it works, level of assurance. We have three levels of robustness: low, medium, and high. The higher the level, the stronger our safety measures are. In simple terms, we're all about making sure our safety measures are top-notch and as strong as they can be. Let's not forget about keeping our drones safe in the sky. We have got something called the air risk class, which helps us figure out how likely it is for a drone to run into a manned aircraft while flying in a specific airspace defined in the CONOPS. To find out the initial air risk, SORA has a handy scheme that takes into account the airspace we're planning to use. Take a look at the article to get a better look. Once the initial air risk is known, we need to determine the necessary mitigation measures to be able to reduce it. Strategic mitigations are all about taking steps before a drone operation to make sure the skies stay safe. It's like planning ahead to reduce risks in the air. This can mean choosing the right time to fly or how long the flight should be. Some of these choices are up to the operator, while others are set by the rules, like how high or how far the drone can go. Tactical airborne risk mitigations are like the safety measures we take while a drone is already up in the air. These are things the pilot and their team do during the flight, like keeping an eye out for other aircraft, see and avoid, and staying in touch with air traffic control services. Once we've put all these safety measures into action, both the ones we planned ahead, strategic, and those during the flight, tactical, we get what's called the residual air risk class value. It's like our safety score in the sky, taking into account things like keeping a close watch for other aircraft, staying in touch with air traffic control, and respecting height and distance limits for drones. This score tells us how well we're managing the risk of collisions up there. Once we have figured out the ground risk class and air risk class final values, we can calculate the SAIL, which stands for specific assurance and integrity level. It's like a confidence rating that ranges from 1 to 6, telling us how robust our safety measures should be. A low SAIL means we need less robust measures, indicating a lower risk operation. But a higher SAIL means we've really beefed up safety, usually for higher risk missions. It's like a safety seal of approval for our drone flights. Now that we have our SAIL index, it's time to roll up our sleeves and apply the right level of robustness to each mitigation measure. This is all about achieving our operational safety objectives, OSO. We've got a handy table that tells us exactly which robustness level to use for each OSO. Check out the article for the full table. The SAIL index we calculated earlier helps us determine these objectives. It's like a roadmap for ensuring our drone operations are as safe as possible. Based on the SAIL index we've obtained, we can determine the desired level of robustness, which falls into these categories. First one, optional; second, low level; third, medium level; and finally, high level. Once we've identified the appropriate robustness level, the next step is to refer to the lists provided by ESA to understand how we can achieve the required assurance and integrity values. Now, as we approach the final stages of this process, there's a crucial step that shouldn't be overlooked: the analysis of the surrounding area and adjacent spaces. While defining our operational volume earlier in the CONOPS phase, we focused on flight geography, the contingency volume, and the safety buffers both on the ground and in the air. But it's essential to look beyond these boundaries and consider what lies outside them. We need to assess the potential risks associated with adjacent areas, both on the ground and in the air. Are these risks greater or lower than those within our defined operational volume, where we've already applied mitigation measures based on the SAIL index we obtained? If the risks are higher, we have to implement specific requirements, such as demonstrating the probability of the UAS escaping from the operational volume in a way that aligns with the risks associated with such an escape, ensuring that no single error, whether from the UAS or external systems, can result in the aircraft leaving the safety buffer, developing software and flight electronics using recognized standards or methodologies accepted by ESA to minimize the chances of escaping the risk buffers. To fulfill these requirements, there might be cases where we need to use external flight termination systems, FTS. These FTS systems have their own specific rules to follow. However, if we can't prove that these requirements are met or guarantee that the FTS works as intended and follows industry standards, then the alternative is to increase the size of our safety buffers on the ground and in the air. This way, we ensure that our aircraft can't go beyond these boundaries, keeping our operations safe and under control. Finally, it's time to bring everything together in the safety report. This report is like our final document that showcases how we've used the SORA methodology. It's important because it helps us demonstrate to the authorities, air navigation service providers, or anyone else involved, how we've gone about ensuring the safety of our drone operations. Check out the article to see all the information the report shall include. For more information regarding SORA methodology, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.